I think the issue at the moment is the cause of the protesters is against a government that has tried to push through an amnesty bill that would grant amnesty to a corrupt former prime minister, the brother of the current prime minister. They are protesting against a government that is refusing to accept the verdict of the Constitutional Court when they were found to have fake documents and be involved in fraudulent voting in Parliament. And therefore, there's a lot of anger and demand now for the government to show responsibility. So the number one priority now, I think, to defuse the situation is that the Prime Minister and the government needs to show that responsibility, to show accountability in the system. Now, the protests have been going on for a month.
Mr. Prime Minister,
it has been largely non-violent, and what they are doing is they are organizing sit-ins as a symbolic gesture that the government no longer has the legitimacy to run the country. The violence that erupted during the weekend resulted from government supporters being mobilized and instigated by members of this government and actually caused losses for the first time. You have to remember that this protest drew record crowd over the last month without any violence. The best way forward now is the government to take that first step to show accountability.
Okay, but what is happening on the streets is clearly that the opposition, the leaders of the protests are calling for action to take over government buildings. What I want to say to you, or what I want to put to you, is this any way for a democracy to be acting, to basically call for the standing down of a democratically elected government to be replaced by an unelected People's Committee? Is that democracy?
I don't think it's democracy when leaders of the government, even though they are elected, try to put themselves above the law. That's the basic issue. Now, the people who are taking to the streets, some of them taking these sit-in actions, they have said that they will accept the legal consequences of their action. It's a form of civil disobedience. And unlike 2010, these protesters are unarmed, and they are willing to accept legal consequences, unlike the government and also the former prime minister, who have refused to accept the law.
But as you pointed out at the beginning of this, the trigger for this has been an amnesty push by the government, which, if it had been passed, would have allowed the former prime minister Thaksin Shinawatra to have returned to Thailand. That bill was rejected by the Senate. So that process means that the issue of Thaksin returning is now no longer on the table, correct? So why do you need to still have protesters on the streets?
That is not right. That is not right. The government had an opportunity after opposition from the House and also on the streets to kill the bill. They didn't do it. They decided instead for an option that makes the bill suspended for the time being. And there is no indication or no assurance that after 180 days that they cannot actually reconfirm this bill. Basically, the government has lost the people's trust. The best way forward is to return power to the people, and they should do it as soon as possible. We don't want to see violence. We don't want to see democratic developments being unraveled. So the best course of action at the moment is for them to show accountability and return power to the people.
You say that the government has lost the people's trust, when in fact, if there was an election, it is likely, according to many pollsters, that the current government leadership would be returned, because there is a lot of support for the government outside Bangkok. So if you are saying you represent the people, you are certainly not representing the majority of the people in Thailand, are you?
As a matter of fact, the last poll that was taken, we were actually ahead. But that's beside the issue. I think the issue now is that in any good or in any well-functioning democracy, leaders need to show accountability. And if they are so sure about winning elections, why don't they return power to the people?
And you would happily welcome an election at any time?
I think it's the first step towards trying to solve the country's problem now. The longer the standoff continues, the bigger the risk, because clearly government supporters have been mobilized. The losses we've seen over the weekend has been the result of government supporters coming in with arms, which in the end caused violence. And now we are also seeing people who are infiltrating into the protest areas and are trying to cause violence. We've seen pictures of police actually firing at protesters despite their denial. We've seen pictures of police using what could even be chemicals against protesters.